Community Kitchen is proudly brought to you by Gemini Catering Equipment at gemcat.com.au. And tonight's episode of Community Kitchen has been proudly supported by the Fox Hotel, Wellington Street, Collingwood, your local pub with great food and booze. Don't forget about their rooftop deck, live music and dining room. For more, go to foxhotel.com.au.
Tonight's show, it's a veggie paella versus roux bolognese showdown with Andy Matthews and Rose Callaghan. Plus, we hear a song from indie rock band Little Dreamer.
Hello, this is Community Kitchen. I'm Laura Davis. We're at the Fox Hotel in Collingwood with Rose Callaghan and Andy Matthews. Double episode. It's pretty fun. I think we should start with Rose.
Yep.
What have you got?
Well, I brought my own apron from home.
It's beautiful.
Because that's really important. Because
you don't want to get any stains on the black dress.
Exactly, and mostly because I'm like really bad at cooking, so I'm just gonna distract with other things.
Don't say mean things about yourself.
Okay, that's
You're
right.
Great at cooking.
I'm good. I'm really good.
Look at this.
Yeah, I know.
Did you do this?
Look, it's just let's not ask too many questions.
All right,
okay.
All right. That's my job, though.
I've got it.
Just, what are you cooking?
I'm going to cook kangaroo bolognese.
Okay.
So it's like normal bolognese, but it's got kangaroo in it.
That's still normal.
Yeah.
It's still normal, I think. What makes you lean towards kangaroo? Ethical reasons? Delicious reasons?
Yeah, because they're really cute and they're delicious. That's why I like kangaroo. Yeah.
I think they're a good meat. It's an ethical meat because they don't require quite as much grazing land
that
and
is
water.
True.
Better for the ozone.
And also, it's got less fat in it, and so it's healthier.
Yeah, you don't tend to see many overweight kangaroos.
No, that's true, because they're too busy kicking people and bouncing around.
Got Andy Matthews. We're going to make this a competition, I think.
Ooh.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
What are you making?
What are you bringing? Your big guns.
A multi-vegetable paella. Paella.
I'm so sorry. Paella. I told you before how
paella.
To say it.
Paella.
Paella.
Paella. Yes, this is a vegetarian dish because I am a vegetarian because...
None of that.
I'm not some kind of monster. So don't slap it. Don't slap the
You don't feel anything
mix.
Anymore.
No. Probably didn't feel that much. Have you ever looked a kangaroo in the eyes?
Yes.
Did you know that kangaroo...
For hours on end.
I heard that kangaroos will go and like if there's like a bunny rabbit or something around the waterhole, they will go, like they're murderers, like they'll go down and they like, I don't know, they kick it or something and then they rip its guts out.
I don't believe it.
It's true. I was in the country 2 weeks ago and my friend told me.
I take it.
Yeah, I don't believe that.
You're completely justified.
They're murderers.
You are doing God's work.
I am. Yeah. There's heaps of them.
I don't believe it at all.
I heard the same thing about capsicums.
My grandmother was killed by a capsicum.
Is it a green capsicum, like a baby capsicum that hasn't yet grown to its full potential?
You're so full of bullshit.
No.
It's actually
Did you hear
I
that in the country
that,
as well? You heard that in the country?
Because they haven't had as much time to live.
Well, get
should
going. You should definitely
this?
Start. Cause I will help if you need it, but I would prefer to remain impartial because the moment I help with my amazing cooking talents, you know, you're going to have a bit of a head start.
So much faster. Why are you not...
Are you pumped for this? But do you think that you're competitive?
Yes, very competitive.
Have you always been competitive?
Yeah, I don't give a shit about things until somebody says the competition, then I'm like, it's on!
How about you? You're dicing that like a pro.
I worked in a kitchen for a while.
Now you tell me.
I've worked in a kitchen all my life.
All your life?
All my life, when I was born.
You were born into servitude.
I was born into servitude.
Yeah, you were a little baby captain.
All of my career life, all of my jobs have involved some sort of cookery.
And here you are.
And here I am.
I thought I wasn't competitive, and then I realised I was just telling myself I was wasn't competitive because that was the way I'd worked out that I could win when I couldn't win, was to be oh, well, I'm not competitive, so it doesn't matter if I lose. But I realised I'm actually hugely competitive.
I don't know how to cut onions. What am I doing?
It's all right. Just don't cry and you win.
Well, that's the thing. I meant to Google how to not cry when you're cutting onions before I got
there. There's a lot of things. You really can't do anything.
I think you should just Google how to not cry. That sounds like an amazing skill.
Have you ever typed in just the start of a question onto Google and you're like...
Yeah.
Because your question is like, how do I change a tire or something? And somebody is there, how do I stop being in love with my cousin? You go, how did you ask that?
If I knew the answer to that, I'd be a rich man.
Yeah. How not to be alone. Oh, God. It's, Google search bar is sad.
I would like to register my first complaint.
You're picking through those beans, Andy.
The recipe calls for broad beans. These, however, are long beans. Somebody doesn't know the difference between width and length. That's an issue.
All right.
It's a kind of dyslexia.
We'll give you a one-point handicap.
What?
Thank you.
Yeah, and you can have a one-point handicap.
Oh, okay.
Just because you clearly need it.
Look how I cut the onion. Chopped up. Just says chopped up. That's chopped up.
That's chopped. Like, you can kind of can do a bit of that action if you want. But
yeah, all right.
It is a bit weepy.
Yeah,
you don't want to weep.
I think it's a good
makeup lady spent a lot of time on our mascara.
Oh, we've got glasses now, though. Andy, do you feel that having glasses helped you not cry
in your life
when you're cutting onions?
I'm definitely a harder man than I would.
And how about alone at night?
I hear that when you're alone at night, putting a bit of water on your wrists
Really
help you.
Goggles.
Not to cry.
Whose lemon is this?
That's mine. I will be slicing that up and
you're
putting
ready.
A little piece of that on the plate.
Oh, wow.
As a garnish.
That is a strong onion.
Well, you've got red onions. I hate red onions. Why do they put red onions in everything? Like in McDonald's, they put red onions in a burger and go like, it's a gourmet burger.
Yeah.
It's not
they're delicious.
It's not.
Oh no.
Whew. We're gonna have to bleep out of your McDonald's wrath.
You know when you go to a fast food restaurant?
Yes.
No particular.
This is an emotional story for you now.
You know when you go to a generic fast food restaurant and they put red onion in everything?
Yeah.
I hate red onions.
Yeah. I don't even trust the white onion that they have there. It's a weird paste they get out of a bucket.
That sounds racist.
Did you know that Andy Matthews
is a dickhead? Yes.
Did you know he's a science teacher? What's your favourite part of science, Andy Matthews?
Physics.
Yep.
Yeah, I like physics. I think it answers all the questions about the universe.
Oh, like why they put red onion on a bloody McDonald's burger. I find physics terrifying. I want to ignore so much of it because people are like, oh, by the way, did you know there's like an electric field, which means that no matter how hard you try, you're never actually touching anything in the world, and you kind of go,
what?
I don't want to know that.
Well, look, but then it just means, well, we just have to have a slightly different definition of what it means to touch something.
Yeah,
you know, because you can't tell me that I'm not touching this thing.
No, you are. It's unhygienic.
If nothing can ever
if
touch anything.
Anything,
then our definition of touch is wrong. We just need a new definition of touch. Just change the definition of touch.
I've complained about a teaspoon.
What's the scariest physics that you know? Like, what's
scariest
the most
physics?
Mind-boggling physics concept?
Okay, well,
what could you destroy my life with right now?
Okay, the universe is not going to blow up at any point. It's not going to come back in and collapse together. It's not going to get to a certain size and then stay there. The universe is just going to expand and expand faster and faster until everything is so spread out and it's such a distant, you know, every molecule is so distant from every other molecule and has so little energy that that the universe just becomes this sort of cold, dead state where it's impossible for anything to ever happen. It's just going to basically just fade away to a cold, infinite nothingness.
Like infinity, that just does
it's like
my
a
head
24 hour Kmart or something like that. Just nothing.
Yes, the universe will not die with a bang, but with a 24 hour Kmart.
Oh man, this is quite a healthy bolognese.
Well, it's got a shitload of bacon in it, so I don't know if it's like that.
This looks healthy.
This is going to be so healthy, guys.
It does.
Healthy. I should be healthier. Like, I'm a vegetarian. Which should be good, but I'm not a vegan, so basically that just means that all I eat is like cheese and bread.
Do you cook in the microwave?
No.
What can you cook in a microwave? You can melt butter.
Rice.
You can cook rice in a microwave?
Yeah, it's way better and it always works.
Yeah, it does.
Everyone's got their thing that they're like, oh, this always works for rice. I don't think there's that.
It's a very controversial issue.
Very controversial.
You know, if somebody says, how do you cook rice? And you're like, oh, if you do it this way, it always works. And then it just doesn't. My ex-boyfriend used to, like, I'd tell him what to do. And then he'd go in and he'd stir it. And I'm like, no, I don't want porridge. I want rice. So then it was just like, I don't know.
I haven't heard they're not stirring it.
You don't stir it. You just leave it.
I want to make sure, Andy, that they didn't edit out the bit where I put this in your hair.
Well, you just have to constantly be putting it in my hair for the rest of the episode.
Because what I'm worried is they would cut it and then it would just appear. It would just appear mid-episode.
And they'll just assume that I'm...
that you did it yourself.
I've gone to sea. Or I did it myself, yeah.
Caramelise this.
Yeah, you got a little way to go. You might need more oil, love.
Okay.
I'm going to help her, all right? But I'll help you with something else later.
I need help.
Fine, I got this. Do you know when you need to start cooking your pasta? Your house in order? You got your business covered? You're all good?
It says in the instructions after this step, that's when I'll start doing it.
It's a lot of smack talk coming from you.
Hey, disguised as thoughtfulness. So.
Do you online date?
Oh, I'm in a relationship.
but
I never have done that.
No?
Because... like, until very recently, that felt like a really shameful thing. All of a sudden, it's cool, and everyone's like, yeah, so this happened on Tinder, and this happened on Tinder, and we've just, like, I reckon in the last year, somehow, like, the society has just shifted. We've had that shift, and
now
it's just like, yeah, this is just what people do now.
I would say changed in the space of, like, a month.
Yeah.
From not Tinder to every single person that I knew having Tinder.
Yeah.
I've been on internet dating for a while, but I'm not into Tinder, because it's too anonymous. For me, it's just like, what friends do you have in common? What Facebook pages do you like? Here are the photos.
I don't trust it.
No.
I've never done it.
And all the people just have the same photos. Them snowboarding the one time they went snowboarding, patting a tiger and at the beach with their shirt off.
Are they bad?
Yeah, they're bad. Last night I was at a gig, actually, somebody had a joke about Tinder, and I was like, oh yeah, haha. And this guy that was at a table next to people I knew just turned around from, like, you know, a little while ago, he goes, you're on Tinder, aren't you? And I was like, what? And he's like, I've seen you on Tinder. And I was like, nice to meet you.
That is weird.
I was wearing the same dress as I was in the Tinder photo.
Yeah, you have to burn that dress.
But I didn't have glasses in the Tinder photo, so...
Ah, perfect disguise.
Yeah, well...
Work for Clark Kent.
Is this caramelised?
Yeah, that's caramelised. Okay. I reckon you can call that. I'm going to take you both away for a bit of a private chat. You can talk smack about each other,
whatever you
want. But we'll take a break and we'll see you soon on Community Kitchen. Just joined us. I'm having a chat with Annie Matthews at the Fox Hotel. Your paella is, were you happy with it? Bubbling away?
I was happy with it when I left, but I don't know, it's taken a while to set up the cameras. I feel like it might be burned by the time we get back.
No.
Hearing you say paella makes me want to start a restaurant or a chain of restaurants called Paella Face.
That could
around
happen.
Around the city where people can get a cheap and hugely disappointing paella. 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 If they can correctly pronounce paella.
Yeah, so. You get a discount if you can do it. 10% off.
Yeah.
Are
my knees in shot?
They're beautiful knees.
Good.
You're doing fine.
They're good knees. Surging up into...
It is a peculiar chair.
I'm in a low... I'm definitely not in the dominant position in this interview. You're definitely going
to
be asking...
Hello, we would like to interview you today for the position of cook. Would you say that cooking is a hobby of yours? A passion?
It's a thing I like to do. But yeah, it's not one of those hobbies where you get home and you're like, oh, I just need to cook something and then I'll feel better.
I don't think we can hire you because your knees are too big.
They're way too prominent.
They're too prominent. Yeah, we can't have those knees in the kitchen.
Pots and pans. It's a small space.
I'll bring mine up to help. What if cooking's not a hobby, what hobbies do you have?
This is like, instead of face-to-face,
it's the worst.
Knee to knee. Knee to knee with Laura Davis.
It's the worst TV show in the world.
Hobbies, I repair bicycles. I enjoy repairing bicycles.
Okay.
Although that's a hobby that I've had to almost sort of sacrifice, because I feel like doing stand-up comedy is almost like a hobby, mm-hmm. right, that takes up as much time as a career.
Yeah.
And then you also have to have a career to support yourself.
Yeah.
So really you've got two careers, one of which is only a hobby, and it's like a super hobby, and then you can't add in another hobby
on top
of your career and your super hobby. There's no room for another hobby in there. So bicycle,
you gotta
pick. Love bicycle maintenance and stuff, but I had to.
I'm so sorry.
Take it out the back and.
I'm in the same boat. I used to do heaps of stuff, and now I just. I just tell jokes. I just yell at people.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I love doing that, so it's fine. But people go, have you ever watched...
This knee thing.
I like it.
Okay.
Have you ever watched a movie? I haven't watched a movie for years. Like, I don't have time to watch a movie. I have three jobs.
No, that's totally true. Like, we don't... you're supposed to be a comedian. You're supposed to, in some way, you know, reflect back to society and that sort of thing. I don't have time for society, okay? I'm trying to write jokes here. I don't have time to absorb any of your culture.
Yeah.
I'll just reflect.
It happens in my house or it doesn't happen. Well, you've been working very hard. Are you running a comedy festival show this season?
I'm doing a comedy festival show. I'm doing my show String Theory that I did at Fringe Festival.
I heard it was excellent.
It went really well. People said very nice things. We sold out some... Sorry, the knees are slipping. We sold out some shows, which was great. And yeah, doing it again. It's like a storytelling show with live electronic musical accompaniment.
That's pretty good. Well, what we'll do is it goes somewhere here on the screen, and we'll get your website and your Twitter handle, and people can...
Over the knees.
Yeah, over the knees would be nice. And they can just go to Comedy Festival website, type in Andy Matthews,
two T's.
Buy 1,000 tickets, and you'll have a great season.
I don't think there even are 1,000 tickets.
Wow. No, they would have to work hard.
They would have to work hard.
But we should go and check on your paella.
We really should.
Because it was lovely having you today and lovely chatting with
you.
I'll go have a chat with Rose. Hey, if you've just joined us, we are at the Fox Hotel with Rose Callaghan. Your bolognese is cooking away.
Yes,
are you happy with it?
Yeah, it's going better than expected.
Is it going better than Andy's paella?
I'd like to say yes, but he seems to know what he's doing, so...
He does. He seems confident. It could all be bravado.
He had heaps of ingredients. Like, he knows what's going on, so...
Right.
I'm a little bit worried, yeah.
You haven't been performing very long as
a
stand-up
really.
Comedian. How long have you been working for?
About 13 months.
Mm-hmm.
Not that I'm counting or anything.
That's exact.
But I am counting still, so, you know. Like, how long have you been doing it for?
A bit over 6 years, I think.
That's a long time, so...
It's a while.
I'm pretty green.
Do you live by yourself?
No, I live with three boys.
Oh, how is that?
It's actually like they're the opposite of what you think of when you think of like living with three boys, because I live in like the northern suburbs. They're like three like really like meek like hipster types that, you know, one of them's a filmmaker, one of them's like doing his doctorate, the other one's like a DJ/lawyer. You know, that's a typical, like...
DJ/lawyer.
Yeah, DJ/lawyer.
It's adorable.
Yeah, they're not, like, they're not, like, get home and they're, like, crunching beer cans on their head and playing, like, FIFA World Cup soccer on, like, video games. They're, like, the opposite of that. If anything, I'm definitely, like, the most boisterous person in the household. Like, they're quite timid. I'm always the one that's getting home at, like, 5 o'clock in the morning being, like, ooh, or, like... Ringing the doorbell at 5 a.m. because I left my house.
Suck.
Yeah,
that's the worst.
Yeah, I know. I'm a bad housemate.
You're bad.
We started doing a cleaning roster. That's pretty
no
bad.
No one wants that.
Because then people start noticing that you never do anything around the house.
Yeah. Do you have a Mukuf season coming up this festival?
I do. It's my first stand-up show in the comedy festival. Last year I did a... improv show with this group I was in called the Improv Conspiracy. So this one is just me and two different comics every night, mm-hmm. and it's called Rose Callaghan and Mates. I was supposed to do a split show for the festival, but my show partner...
Your splitter.
Saren got picked by the comedy festival to do Comedy Zone.
That's great.
Yeah, which is great for him. Bloody good on you, Saren. Like, I hope he goes... I'm happy for
you. You would barrel that down the camera?
Good luck with your show and whatever. That's good. I'm really happy for him.
People can go to the Comedy Festival website and type in Rose Callaghan and Mates and they can see a little bit more of you.
So it's like it's me and two different comics doing stand-up every night. So I kind of host it and do a bunch of material. And, I've got really good people on, like Harley Breen and Josh Earl and Geraldine Hickey.
That's a good lineup.
Luke McGregor and stuff. And then,
can I be on?
Yeah, you can be on.
Good.
I was going to ask you later, but whatever.
But we should go and test our food and see who is the winner of our paella bolognese battle.
Okay.
Community Kitchen, and we have our final paella bolognese duel. Are you ready?
Yes.
Are you ready to taste it?
Totes.
Because you can taste both, Andy. You don't have to eat any of our national
emblem.
You don't
have to, but you know, in the spirit of the program, you really should.
You will be offended.
Thank you. I want to give you a good selection of everything that's in here.
It's not breaking vegetarianism if it's for TV.
That's true.
Yeah,
I've heard that.
If this doesn't taste good, I would like to.
All right, one of you is going to have to take this well. I want you to. I'm gonna call it.
Okay.
And I didn't have any sherry, and I didn't have the right paprika.
We already
it's
gave
long beans, not broad beans.
We already gave you a handicap for that. Mmm.
The time
delicious
didn't go in mine. The T H Y N E.
All right, I like them both.
Yeah.
And I think that I like them both equally, actually.
Oh, come on.
No.
But
with Andy's broad bean handicap,
what?
He wins.
Oh,
all right,
bullshit.
Rose. Are you all right with that? But you can take all of your bolognese home.
Okay, all right, that's good then. That'll keep me going for a week. I'll bloody turn into a kangaroo by the end of the week. Hey? Anyway.
I think that's the best place we can leave it.
Yeah.
I don't think we can do better than that. Before we go, thank you very much for coming on the show, both of you.
It
was lovely chatting with you. Thank you to the Fox Hotel, and thank you to Little Dreamer. We'll see you next week.
Drifting away, I can't hear you no more in the further. get, the closer to decisions that I will regret. It's not about you. It's not about you anymore. It's not about you. It's not about you anymore.
Episode of Community Kitchen was proudly supported by the Fox Hotel, Wellington Street, Collingwood.